Last time on Let's Play Mega Man X4 in the Zero playthrough. Zero is a Jedi. Why didn't you tell me about this turn of events? Because of honor and all that noise, they later fight anyway. Stomp the coup out on his boot. Screw you, Gah! You ruined my day! We are the Eggmen. And who's the walrus? You're greeting someone named Susan? And the answer to that last question is that it's Paul. Why is everyone in this story a complete idiot? Shouldn't it be Blue Susan? Why would you reference a game that hasn't even come out yet? Maybe he'd actually listen if you didn't try to kill him, you absolute dummkopf! And now the continuation. It's time to head into my yard, the jungle, but this is the Mississippi King, so my yard is a jungle, I guess, and I'm welcoming y'all back to more Let's Play at Mega Man X4 in the Zero playthrough. In the last episode, we defeated a number of Mavericks, including Split Mushroom, and Paul, because he's the walrus, you see. And the walrus, as we all know, was Paul. But now, at this point in the game, Zero is pretty well outfitted. He's turned into a proper Jedi because of his techniques. And may as well show off Ship Yuga, because that's a decent ability. It's a little finicky to pull off, but it is kind of cool. But thanks to Zero's weapon, his Z-Saber, you're not even trying to hide the Star Wars parallels at this point. He has an elegant weapon for a more civilized age. This series is turning into Star Wars references, apparently. But it's kind of appropriate since Zero is a Jedi, basically. But this game, unfortunately, is kind of the peak of the series, because, like, after this, it's really all downhill from here. Now, I actually am one of the few people who enjoy, well, I wouldn't say one of the few, I'm in the camp of people who enjoy X5. I get that not everyone agrees with me in that front, but I think it has enough redeeming qualities to make it worth the pain. It's not perfect, of course, I acknowledge that. X5 is still inferior to this game. And, it's basically all downhill from here until we get to X8, which, like, I'll talk more about that later, but, let's just say I have opinions that differ significantly from the popular majority when it comes to X8. So, a fun detail about Web Spider, he actually posed a bit of a nuisance in recording the Japanese audio, but this time it was because I was being an idiot, because as it turns out, Web Spider is the only one of the 8 Mavericks that only has 2 voice lines in the Japanese version instead of 3. So I was, like, getting obsessed about, like, trying to collect all 3 of the Japanese lines, when in reality, he only has 2, and I got them. So that was a bit tricky, a bit of an ordeal. But, what's not going to be an ordeal is backtracking as a Zero. Because, as it turns out, I've actually taken a route that unknowingly, it means that I actually will have zero backtracking, no pun intended. So because of that, we're actually going to collect all of the things and we can just head straight on to the final set of stages, which is nice, I guess. My routes for Zero just generally involve less backtracking because I collect the most useful techniques, or rather, my favorite techniques. And these routes often involve no backtracking. Ah, Zero. I've been expecting you.
Spider, you work for Repliforce?
Yes, I lead a renegade unit now.
There's still time. Call off the coup.
No, I know where my loyalties lie.
ここを通すわけにはいかんのだ。この攻撃、かわせるか。
So it's time to get into the fight with the web spider and Zero. On a side note, his Japanese name is Web Spiders, which is weird, but okay. I'm not sure what's up with that, but I'm not actually sure how to use his weakness. Apparently it's Ship Yuga, but I have no idea how you're supposed to, like, actually hit him. It may be, like, some sort of, I guess maybe when he's doing this in his second phase, maybe you can pull it off, but it's a little tricky to do that. Apparently it can be done, but anyway, he's fairly easy. Boneless. Revert. Spine Transfer. Acid Drop. Kick Flip. Double Kick Flip. I'm running out of Tony Hawk moves. I'm not that familiar with Tony Hawk moves, if I'm being honest. But anyway, yeah, the weapon, the technique, excuse me, I'm getting the two playthroughs mixed up now, is called Raging Gecko, because I guess the way that, like, it shoots lightning straight in front of you resembles an angry gecko. It's a bit of a strange name if you ask me, but apparently the name means Thunder God Attack, which is so corny. I'm telling you, all of these technique names, they're just so corny and over the top if you translate them. But yeah, it's just a simple attack where you stab straight in front of you. It's not the most useful attack, but it does come in handy in a few places. We're getting to, like, some of the lesser good techniques, so this is definitely one of them. It's not great, but what is great is this stage, Air Force. Before I talk about that, I should mention that apparently Storm Owl's Japanese name is Storm Fukuro, but it's pronounced as, like, Storm Fukuro, which is weird. Like, what happened to the second syllable in that word? But I digress, that's not related to the stage itself. But apparently Fukuro is, like, a compound of, like, the Japanese word for owl and the English word for owl, which is weird. That's like calling him Lechusa Owl. It just makes no sense. But this stage itself is quite incredible. It's got a lot of spectacle, and it feels very good to go through. There are tons of enemies and challenges, and it just feels really enjoyable. What can I say? This game has a lot of enjoyable stages, and also the music to the stage, I would be remiss if I didn't mention this, is also incredible. I love this game's soundtrack, as I've stated on numerous occasions. This is no exception. It's also one of my favorite tracks in this game. The mini-boss here is very easy to cheese because, like, the mini-bosses basically have, like, zero invincibility frames. They have, like, no invincibility, so it's very easy to, like, get tons of residual damage onto them. With, like, Ku and Zant, you can get tons of hits in. But that's all for the mini-boss. Now let's head straight to the fight with a Storm Owl. Which is actually kind of an interesting fight as a Zero, because, like, he actually has a platform that you can use for leverage. And you can, I think, access it as X, but it's a little harder. Zero has, like, a double jump, so that makes it easier. But X can also reach the platform with either a pixel-perfect jump or the lightning web. It also can be a little tricky to fight him as a Zero, because, like, he can also, like, grab you, and that hurts for, like, pretty major damage. You'll want to, like, keep your distance. Well, I mean, he can also grab you as X, but, like, with Zero, you have to get all up close and personal, which can make it a little risky to deal with him. He is harder as a Zero, but he's still pretty easy. And the technique he gives you is called Ten Koopa. Because if someone throws a Koopa shell at you as a Zero, then, like, his Z-Saber can now erase that shot, which is why it's called that. Koopa shells no longer would harm you if you attack them, so that's kind of neat. But apparently, the name translates to Aether Rule, which isn't as corny as some of the other technique names, but it is still kinda corny. Now we're moving on to Cyberspace, the final stage of Zero's playthrough of the main Mavericks. Kuanzant actually works really well in this stage because, like, it actually makes the yellow spheres disappear, and these things can trap you, so you'll want to rely on Kuanzant a lot to breeze through this stage. And because of that, it should be very easy to get an S rank and get the heart tank. I should talk about something else. Apparently, Cyber Peacock's Japanese name is a Cyber Kujacker, but for some reason it's pronounced as Cyber Kjacker. I have no idea what happened to the first syllable in that word, but okay. And I have no idea what that's supposed to be. Like, is that supposed to be some kind of hacker? Or, like, hijacker? I have no idea. It's weird. But apparently his technique is called Rock You Hoo-Ha, which is, like, I didn't expect that they'd be getting all political up in here. That's so weird. Like, now all of a sudden, the developers are praising uproars and hoo-has, which is, like, such a strange thing for this game to be doing. It's not something I was expecting. But, I mean, I guess they can do that. It's their game, after all. But anyway, apparently the name translates to Falling Phoenix Crush, which is, again, so corny. These technique names are just super corny. It's like they were written by internet edgelords, all of them. The technique names definitely sound like they could have been written by edgelords trying to sound cooler than they actually are. What's more, its name is also incorrect, because, like, it doesn't fall, it goes up. Like, it shoots projectiles in a quarter, half circle, actually, and they don't go down. So, like, it's also an incorrect name, in addition to sounding like it was created by internet edgelords. But in all seriousness, It actually is an alright weapon technique. I mean, there I go again getting them mixed up. But it's not great. It's one of my least favorite techniques in this game. But it is reasonably powerful. However, its big drawback for me is that it's also the only technique that requires weapon energy. That prevents me from, using it as much as I'd like. It's basically Zero's version of the Giga Attack. It's even activated with the same button as X's Giga Attack, which for me is the triangle button. Again, it's alright. Also, something I forgot to mention about Ten Koopa is that it actually changes your Z Saber to purple, which is interesting. It does look kind of cool. Purple kind of reminds me of Mace Windu's lightsaber. Why can't I forget about the prequels? That's one thing that really gets me. Anyway, the Cyber Peacock is pretty easy with his weakness, which is the Ryu engine. It works really well against him. This was the technique I was talking about in the last episode that Zero could use with the weapon tank. However, it's the only technique like that, so the weapon tank is basically useless as Zero. And the next cutscene reveals that Repla Force is in fact going
to the one place that hasn't been corrupted by capitalism. Space!
I'm going to run that joke into the ground and you can't stop me. You thought you were done hearing about communism. And yes, the joke about space was already made by Johnny. I'm well aware of that. And these folks, I'm telling you, they're communists. No, I'm just kidding, but in all seriousness, Spaceport has one of my favorite themes in this entire soundtrack. It just feels very urgent, and it adds sort of like this fantastic feeling to it. I don't know how to describe it, but it fits the stage just so well, and it's also just kind of a really cool emotional track, in addition to being very catchy. But Spaceport is also one of the greatest stages in this game, even though it's woefully short, and that's a bit of a drawback to it. But it's designed in a way that, tests your mastery of Zero's techniques and of X's weapons, because, so many enemies are in places that would just be really inconvenient to attack with, your regular attack. So it's really cool that, you get to show off in this stage. The stage is just so good. I don't know how they managed to make it this good, but, it really does feel like they hit all the right notes, both figuratively and literally, because the music I hear is fantastic as well. And, it's just a great stage all around. And, like I said, the only problem is that it's woefully short. In fact, we're already coming up to the end. It's that short. And, since we're now going to be fighting the Colonel in this stage, that's what I'm going to place the info card for the Colonel. That's when we're going to, see his information. And for this and all subsequent bosses, I'm going to be using the English lines, because they actually have English lines for this and all subsequent bosses. And they mean basically the same thing as the Japanese lines.
I don't want to fight! Step back! I'm sorry. I can't let you through. Iris will be sad if she loses you. Don't be so presumptuous, Zero. Save it until after you've defeated me.
Show me what you've got. I'll show you no mercy. Now get ready. I've been waiting to fight with you.
So, I died to this fight off-screen. Because, of course, that's what happens, I guess. This isn't even a particularly hard fight. Yet, I somehow managed to, screw up really bad and die to this guy multiple times. Because, of course, I'm the Armand White of video game difficulty. Yep. I'm never going to stop using that joke since it's so true. Everything hard is easy, everything easy is hard for me. So it seems. But yeah, this fight is just incredible. It's one of the best boss fights in this game because, it's so exciting and everything's going on all at once. I like it, what can I say?
Impressive, Zero. But it's too late. What? Replica Force has left for the space. Even if I perish, Replica Force lives. Colonel! Zero, tell Iris that her brother died happily. Goodbye, Zero. Colonel!
Yep, so he dies. There's a Spanish meme in particular that I'm thinking about that I desperately want to use, but, I don't think anyone would get it since I think most of my audience speaks English. That's completely out of the blue. I don't know what I'm talking about anymore. I'm crazy. I'm losing my mind. So you know what? I'm not going to use that Spanish meme, and I'm instead going to use a completely different Spanish meme that you weren't expecting because I'm such a genius.
Maravillosa jugada.
But, yeah, that will have to be it for this episode. This is the Mississippi King signing out. And, join me next time for the finale of Let's Play Mega Man X4 in the Zero playthrough. See y'all then, folks!